Hi, welcome back to Sea Crowds. We present today Storm 57 number one in his ZAO. We got this replay from the European Community Group, and so we comment in English. I will do my very best to let you enjoy the replay and understand me, hopefully. We are on Sierra del Fuego, and we show you first the skill and the upgrades from the vessel. The captain skills priority target is he see how many other captains aim his vessel. Expert marksman for the returning speed, adrenaline rush, reduce reloading. Basic firing training, demolition expert for a higher possibility to get enemies burned, and concealment expert for a lower detectability from the enemy. Together with the upgrades, magazine mod 1, main battery mod 2, better turning speeds for the cannons. In gunfire control system mod 1, better accuracy, damage control system mod 1, steering gears modification 2, faster rudder shift time, concealment system mod 1, lower detectability by the enemies. Okay, as you see, I increased the play speed for the first minute to get fast in action. He moves to A. Together with his teammates from Nighthammer Imperial Fleet. Storm 57 drives the ZAO, Finitam, the Izumo, and Ranger H, the Montana. The first enemy is in sight. He going to cap alone A, as he is the only ship what is visible. I think due to the fact the most vessels on sea, he is alone in A. I don't understand that. I see it. I see it too in my random battles very often that somebody tries to cap alone something with a cruiser or battleship with the high detectability. The Hilber is already burning, and he reloads the high explosive shells, getting ready the shells, and fire. Burning one time, defend one time, and a damaged module on the vessel of the Hilber. Now he is rushing in A to avoid the cap, and you want him, want to kill him. He is alone, and he gets the support from the Montana and from the Izumo. Sorry for the graphical issue on the below, but it's a replay issue. Okay, there is the Hipper, the final seconds of the Hipper in this game. Okay. One second more. Now the Hipper is gone away. Only 5 minutes 30 seconds in the game. That's what happens if you drive alone. Now he checked the situation, what he is doing next, and capping A. Capped the next targets, Iowa, Großer Kurfürst, Montana on the right hand side. Really important for a Zhao, keep this vessel moving. Keep this vessel moving. If you're going to attack a vessel, don't stay around or drive slow. Use the high speed and the fast rudder shift time. I don't have the Zhao, but everybody do the Zhao on this way. I am really struggling with them if I have the Zhao as an enemy. He correct his course to use the rock. Two times fire on deck on the Iowa. 22k damage till now. Three times burning. And the damage ticking away. Montana don't look to the Zhao, and he has an easy game. Okay. Now the Montana shoots. Corrected the course and tried to check the Zhao, but that was nothing. Surprising shoot. The four turrets with the three cannon tubes on each turret are really massive. And the burning possibility without any skills of 19% to gather with the demolition expert, you can reach 21%, and if you have flags mounted on the vessel before your fight, 203 millimeters on each cannon means 2 extra percents for burning possibility. Totally 23rd% with 12 shells would be great. There's the island. Don't park there. Montana is about to leave his hide, and he sets the top behind the rock. 10 torpedoes with a range of 8 kilometers. And goes a Kurfürst. Can pick the Bratwurst on deck. Looks like two fires on deck. And will there be a third fire? Yes, there is a third fire, so everyone can pick his Bratwurst on deck. So, Montana is gone away with four torpedoes. That's quite great. Quite great gameplay. He used every weapon on the vessel and uses every chance to hide. Next shells in the air. Another burning. Kurfürst should be the last target on the north of the map. The rest of the team red is on a is in next to C and is about to move to B, I suppose. Now I can use it the time to explain this out a bit more in detail. It's a blueprint from 1941, As you know, maybe the vessel was never built. It's only a blueprint vessel. Standard visibility is 12.6 kilometer in the water from other vessels, and if you are a pilot, you see the vessel on 9.3 kilometers. But Storm 57 skills a concealment expert and so on, uses the right camouflage, so you can decrease the concealment to 9.7 kilometers, and that's really great for this kind of vessel. You have a shooting range for of 18.8 kilometers, and you're only visible on 9.7 kilometers. You have always the chance to drive away, and you should use the distance to have enough time to react if the enemy shoots on you. What we already saw, he has four torpedo launchers with five tubes with a range of 8 kilometers, outstanding speed 76 knots, and alpha damage from 21k. As you see, the maximum speed, he increases the speed already. He has the flex on board, but the standard speed is 34.5 knots with a rudder shift time of 7.7 seconds. With the flex, high speed testing, 36.2 knots, and the upgrade rudder shift time. You shoot a rudder shift time around 5.6 seconds. The thickest armor on the vessel is 203 millimeters, not very much for a cruiser, but it's a Japanese cruiser. If you hit the Zhao, you hit the Zhao very often very hard. It's not too hard to hit the Zhao. Correct. Oh, the mooring is also easy hit. First citadel for him, and the next salvo is out. With the next citadel, and the mooring is destroyed. But there is a Grosser Kurfürst on 11 kilometers, and now he should switch to high explosive 2700, and he leave. Run, Zhao, run. A priority target. On the other side, you see another member of the clan, Nighthammer Imperial Fleet, Dylan. We have already launched a replay of Dylan in his Missouri. A very special playstyle. As far as I know, Dylan has left the clan now, but I don't know more details. It's he did it in a positive way, I think. What can we do for the clan? What can we say for the clan? I mean, he is founded in December 2016, has 30 members, and accept international players, but you has to speak French. Storm 57 is a leader, and the clan will will grow if the new clan options are available, maybe at end of the September 2017. That's what I know, what I got from Storm 57 via email. Situation is 3-on-3 now. Team Red has 2 cap points and Team Green only 1. More than 200 points back. And he do it right. He driving away to keep the distance between the battleship and Zhao as great as possible. Have enough time to react. High caliber dropped. Another salvo. Extinguish the fire on deck. Supporter dropped for the Zhao. $220,000 of damage. And another fire. Every salvo is a fire on deck. Oh, there is an island. Really surprising. Yeah, he don't shoot to use his low visibility, and nobody can shoot him. 2-on-2. The Team Green has now 1 vessel more, but no chance. They must destroy the enemy vessels to get this. 1:30 left. Going to be tough to turn this game. If you interesting to see your replay on YouTube, use the email address in the description, ccrowds@gmail.com. Send us your 6 screens. Yes, 6 screens. The 4 final screens, a screen of your captain skilling, of your captain skills, and a screen of your upgrades on the vessel. Then I will see the replay file. We will check the content and we'll let you know if we release it on our YouTube channel. If you are from the European Community Group or international player, we will comment the replay in English. If you are a German speaking player, we will release our replay, the replay in German. Now the minute is over. Unfortunately, a loss, but a really great game from my point of view. That's the final screens. Hope you enjoyed this replay. If so, please leave a like, leave a subscription. If you like to know more about ccrowds, visit us on facebook.com/ccrowds. Hope to see you next time. Have a great day and see you. Bye bye.